once you've done your enterprise skills assessment, now you got to figure out how do you apply that skills assessment knowledge across talent processes, right? How do we tap into internal talent? How do we know the skills that are required for success on a job ahead of time so we can accelerate the identification of internal talent for these new roles? Then once we have that, we also want to sense demand signals for new skills. What are the hot skills? What are people going after? What courses are important? Where are people putting their energies, both on the demand side and the supply side? How do we develop new skills in real time, especially in areas where we've got hot technologies, where we want to think about training and development, think about reskilling? How do we create programs to deliver rapid and more frequent training programs and improve the training library, helping people understand the link between certain types of skills that are in demand with upward mobility? Updating a skills profile, updating their skills inventory actually gives them more opportunities to do the things that are more aligned with their work-life balance or, of course, their career goal aspirations. Well, we're going to see AI and ML engines create new job roles and descriptions that we've never thought of before, where we're mixing matching skills to create new positions based on need and demand. Analytics, automation, and AI are very interesting to me. How we actually automate employee experiences and journeys that are across the way. And then more importantly, how we actually build what we call a business graph, the ability to actually keep learning and building that tribal knowledge in a digital core. And I think that's important where we can actually see those opportunities kind of emerge. And then of course, AI and VR, like AR and VR are very interesting to me. The augmented reality, virtual reality pieces, I think they're transforming the way we learn and we experience things. I think the important part is to have a continuous learning culture and really make learning fun again. And I think that's important for people to have that, that environment where people just enjoy learning, they celebrate it, they understand it's a lifelong approach.
What's happening today is technology and automation are fundamentally transforming roles. So half of a job might still exist and the other half might change into something totally different. And a lot of the skills we thought we had might not apply anymore. And skills we need might be adjacent skills. Many companies don't even track the skills beyond the job that the person's in. They may have a whole host of skills that could be relevant for a next generation of activities and work that we don't even know because we only tracked the skills directly relevant to the job they were hired into in the first place. A lot of this dynamic reskilling has to happen not only in the classroom, even if it's intense, sort of experiential kind of learning. Until you really get on the job, it's hard to get to a level of mastery, which requires us to think much more comprehensively and holistically about skilling. It's not just a single skill, it's often the integration of multiple micro skills, which goes back in some ways to that, updating the profile. It's not just updating the profile for an individual, it's their peers, their bosses, their colleagues, commenting on how are they doing on these skills. It's constant feedback. It's constantly getting better at the gaps and closing the gaps as the requirements in the job change. It's not a one and done kind of activity where you just reskill, train people up and they're done. It is a phased approach. You first have to understand what are the skills we have today and what are the skills we need? And what are some of the foundational competencies and adjacencies that would lend one person in a role to be an eligible and prospective good candidate for upskilling or reskilling for new work. And another person in the exact same role who's well-performing, who might not have some of the foundational competencies or adjacent skills that would suggest they would be equally successful in some new work. Increasingly, we're seeing real value creation in companies, innovation, execution, new product launches coming from cross-functional teams. And not only do you have to have the right skills in individual roles and jobs, you need to have the right skill mix on a team. If you understand the micro skills needed, not only for individual roles, but also on a team and create that dynamic teaming of skills, that's where the future is really headed. Well, one of the things I think you're going to start to see is people starting to build out their ontology of skills beyond just the skills that people have in the job they're in today. Because all of their own skill data is focused on the person in the job they're in today. And they've missed all of the skills that the person has acquired from other experiences that aren't formally tracked in the system of record. So I think the system of record itself is going to have to change. It's going to have to get broader. And we're going to have to get better at how do we integrate over time a skill mix and development paths. I think with all of the automation and all of the AI and all of the digitization, what we're also going to see is the work that remains for humans to do will be increasingly human. And a lot of those human skills we do not measure or track very well. We sometimes say things like they are a good leader, which is very broad. Does that mean they have empathy and compassion? Does that mean they're visionary and inspiring? What does that actually mean? And we're going to have to get better and better at understanding the soft skills. You need to constantly be working on how do we get better at skilling, upskilling, mastery, incentivizing learning, helping develop an apprentice, soft skills as well as hard skills, and even nurturing and developing some meta skills around openness to new experience and learning agility and adaptability. These are things that can be learned. So helping people learn how to learn is itself a skill that we can invest in.